Okay, so this is a little modified CLT-6 for SeaWorld, and we're going to look at the lock bar here. It's easy to get this thing backwards, but when it's correct, the lock bar will slide out and be removed, and in and back out. And this will line up here so you can slip in your lock. And this is a pretty standard lock, and there's plenty of room to get a lock bar in there. If this isn't lining up, it's easy to get backwards. I can have these lids reversed like this. It looks like everything is okay, but the lock bar is not going to work. I'm not going to line up here. I'm going to miss it. And they have to be set properly. This lip is for the top lid. This is my top track. This is my bottom track. So we're going to switch these around. Bottom. So that's the proper setup. This should close all the way to the outside frame. And now my lock bar is over, back, and again, the lids are locking up. Other things, take the lock bar off. So the lids pop off, and inside we've got baskets for product. And the baskets, I think the baskets will come out. But this frame removes, pops right out. No tools needed, just pops right out. That lets you, now I can remove the baskets. We have down here inside, we have a couple of runners to keep the baskets off the bottom. We don't want them sitting on the bottom. If it gets wet, they might get welded, frozen into the bottom. So they sit on a couple of tracks that are just placed in there loose. And that goes back on. Now the frame is square or symmetric. It can go in either way. It doesn't really matter which way it goes, but note the lip high, the lip low. This is my top lid mating here, my bottom lid mating there. So that's wrong. That's right. And I did a little magic trick here. I actually switched the lock bar around. And it doesn't really matter which way you go here. As long as you have the top lid on the top track, the bottom lid on the bottom track, and now my slot lines up. This is the service side of the compressor, of the cart, the vent. We have the digital control that shows you the display. These left the factory set for minus 20 degrees. And over here are labels, serial number information, and here is how to set the temperature control. And then there's caution, you got moving parts in there. This is not for the staff to adjust. This requires removal of this panel to have access to that control to change the temperature. This should only be done by service technicians or qualified people that can stick their hands on a fan motor or fan blade or something like that. The other thing I'm bringing in, this is my air intake, that's my air exhaust. We are deflecting the air out that way. However, if we obstruct this too much, I like to have 3 to 5 inches clearance here. If I'm tight against here with another cart, I'm going to force the air back into here. And so we want 3 to 5 inches minimum, 3 inches, like to have 5 inches of ventilation, especially when we're outside and it's 80 and 90 degrees. That's it.